Usually, my day starts around 8 a.m., just getting ready in the morning like anyone else would. Around 9 a.m., my day as a SciTech student officially begins with work in my research lab. I currently work under Dr. Karen Gamble in the Department of Psychiatry in UAB School of Medicine. Dr. Gamble's lab is primarily concerned with behavioral neurobiology research, specifically looking at circadian rhythms and how light-dark cycles affect the brain. My current project involves running mice through different types of mazes and tasks to measure the effects of these cycles on learning and memory. As an undergraduate in the lab, I've had the opportunity to learn a great deal thus far under the direct mentorship of Dr. Gamble and the graduate students in the lab. Depending on the experiment, I could be here for as little as 30 minutes or as long as 3 hours. It depends on the experimental design and the overall duration of the experiment.
Unlike Mugdha's morning, I start my day off like most college students with class. One of my first classes of the day, biomaterials, is a class specific to biomedical engineering majors. In this class, we study known material and tissue interaction and examine relevant scientific literature to create and propose new ideas. A lot of the times, I like to take free time in the morning and early afternoon to work on some extracurricular projects. As one of two captains on the Ultimate Frisbee team at UAB, I work with my co-captain and the coach to plan our evening practices and organize the roster and tournament schedules for our team. While I have some administrative duties planning our trips across the Southeast, most of the work I do is on the field. I've actually been recognized as a potential nominee for the Gulf Coast Section Player of the Year, so I guess all that practice is actually paying off.
After I'm finished with lab, it's time to head off to classes for the day. On Tuesdays and Thursdays, I head to my SciTech 299 class around this time. One of the main goals of the Science and Technology Honors Program is getting undergraduates involved with research during their time here at UAB, and providing them with the tools they need to succeed in this area. SciTech 199, Introduction to the Scientific Process, is the first SciTech class every SciTech student takes as a freshman. In this class, I was guided on incorporating basic concepts of scientific methodology into evaluating a scientific journal article. I analyzed a paper on learning, memory, and synaptic plasticity by Dr. Lori L. McMahon with a group of my peers, and presented that analysis in a poster presentation at the end of the semester. SciTech 201 is a research approaches class. Several different sections of this class are offered, and each is tailored to a different area of research. Last spring semester, I took the research approaches to biotechnology class. Under the mentorship of Dr. Tino Unlap, I gained some valuable hands-on experience with research methods, including cell culture, electrophoresis, PCR, and many more. SciTech 299, the class I'm currently enrolled in, is an interdisciplinary seminar with several sections from faculty from different disciplines. The Neurobiology of Learning and Memory class, taught by Dr. Garrett Koss and Dr. Kristen Gavin, focuses primarily on developing skills in hypothesis testing and experimental design in order to formulate a mock neuroscience research proposal by the end of the semester. These SciTech classes have really helped to guide my scientific comprehension and learning in my path of undergraduate research.
After my morning classes, I usually put in some hours in my research lab, which contributes to credit hours needed to graduate from SciTech. I currently work under Dr. Joel Berry, who focuses on cardiovascular biomechanics and tissue engineering. I was introduced to Dr. Berry when he was my professor for the SciTech Research Approaches class. I enjoyed the way he approached his classes, and I found his commitment to practical undergraduate education very interesting. In my current project, I'm working on stage one of creating synthetic atherosclerotic arterial vessels to use as models for drug testing. This involves development of the arteries and testing of mechanical performance in a pulsatile flow bioreactor. STH 345 is the Honors Proposal Preparation Seminar. In this class, students who've been in a research lab for at least one semester work to complete their research proposals and defend them in front of a panel of faculty. My fellow peers and I will be working together to discuss and provide input about one another's research aims and goals over the course of the next semester. After that, it'll be on to STH 400, the honors thesis preparation in the form of a scientific article and thesis defense.
In addition to my SciTech course load and my neuroscience major, I'm also pursuing a fast-track program to a master's degree in public health. My degree will be concentrating in health behavior, which is essentially understanding what motivates individuals to take actions and make decisions involving their health. After my SciTech 299 class, I go to one of my master's classes, HB 624, which is Advanced Theory and Practice. In this class, We focus on looking at theoretical models of behavior and motivation and try to apply them to health behavior interventions. At this point in my day, like any student concerned with their health and well-being should, I take the opportunity for a lunch break. For me, lunch is more than a meal. It's an experience. I consider myself an epicure, and it's one of the most relaxing parts of my day to be able to enjoy a nice meal and write about it on my food blog. On my blog, I write about local restaurants, coffee shops, and other places to grab a fine bite to eat here in Birmingham.
STH 151 is a project planning class in which students either design and plan their own projects or approach previously established projects in new ways. In STH 250, students follow through with their leadership or innovation projects and prepare a public presentation of the project's strengths and weaknesses. My project requirement for this class was actually fulfilled by a class called GHS 220, which is a service learning class modeled in a similar way to STH 151 and 250. In this class, I worked with a group to data mine EPA records for various manufacturers located along the Cahaba River for unreported dumping violations. I'm currently working to assist some of the STH 250 groups, including the Peer Mentoring Committee and the SciTech video crew that worked on producing this video.
In addition to my class schedule, I'm also involved in a lot of other activities on campus. For one, I'm the Programs Coordinator for the Student Services Division of Undergraduate Student Government Association. As the Programs Coordinator, it's my responsibility to plan USGA-sponsored educational and social events for the entire UAB student body, including UAB's Fall Festival, the Spring Picnics, and Town Hall Meetings. At the Town Hall Meetings, we discuss a variety of topics, from safety on campus to student satisfaction with dining options. We also cover specialized topics, including the revival of UAB's football, bowling, and rifle programs. In the afternoons on Tuesdays and Thursdays, I hold office hours in the Rec Center for planning town hall meetings, booking rooms, filing requests for purchases, ordering food and supplies, and requesting publicity for events. I also work with the Office of Student Multicultural and Diversity Programs on campus, which includes the Multicultural Council and peer educating programs. As Public Relations and Programming Coordinator of the Multicultural Council, I'm involved with hosting monthly identity-based programs that celebrate different cultures and function as a platform to talk about social injustice facing those underrepresented communities. I also hold office hours on Monday and Wednesday afternoons for planning certain events, including the Poetry Out Loud Poetry Slam and co-organizing catering for the International Bazaar. As Coordinator of Public Relations, I manage Multicultural Council's social media outlets and provide quotes pertaining to our events for Kaleidoscope, the student newspaper on campus.
In the evenings on the weekends, I volunteer with Rape Response at the Crisis Center. I serve as one of the many volunteer-trained staff that aid in consoling survivors. We are there for survivors during the medical examination process, and also discuss legal options and plans of self-care with them after. I really feel like I can make a difference in this role by being there for individuals in times of great hardship.
On Sunday and Wednesday nights, I volunteer my time with a youth group at Our Lady of Sorrows Catholic Church in Homewood. Working with this youth group is my biggest way of giving back to the Birmingham community. After I went away to college, I saw a lot of my friends fall away from their faith, and I want to make sure that doesn't happen to these kids. I volunteer for about 6 hours a week, participating in and facilitating group bonding and faith-based activities.
Every other Sunday night, I have a meeting to attend for the Science and Technology Honors Executive Council. The Exec Council is a council of 11 students that are elected by the SciTech student body to serve as representatives of the entire honors community. Last year, I served as the social chair and was involved in planning social events for the SciTech student body. This year, in addition to mentoring the new social chair, I serve as a recruitment chair and head of the recruitment committee. My current duties include organizing interviews for prospective SciTech students, sending committee members to UAB Day to talk about the program, and training members of my committee to deliver presentations in their hometown about SciTech at UAB.
Last year, I served on the Executive Council with Mugdha as the Peer Mentoring Chair, and I served as the Intramurals Chair the year before that. As the Intramural Chair, I organized SciTech student intramural teams and presided over all the team captains. As the Peer Mentoring Chair, I worked with the Peer Mentoring Committee to pair incoming freshman SciTech students with upperclassmen mentors with similar personalities, majors, and career goals. While I am no longer on the Executive Council, I am still a peer mentor and serve on the Peer Mentoring Committee. Upperclassmen within the Science and Technology Honors Program that serve as peer mentors are matched with incoming SciTech freshman students at the freshman retreat. These mentors, like Mugdha and myself, serve over the following year as a resource and friend for their mentees to help them adjust to college life.
This past year, the program has been altered to resemble a family system, in which two upperclassmen mentors are paired with 4 to 5 mentees. This family system has helped to build a stronger connection between upperclassmen and underclassmen within the program. The Peer Mentoring Committee also plans several fun events to facilitate interaction between mentors and mentees, like the kickoff party at the beginning of the year or family feud night.
Bye!
Bye.
See you guys.
Well, I think that about wraps up the day.
While every SciTech student may not be as involved in student government as Mugdha,
or be as athletic as Ethan,
we're all still part of the same SciTech family.
Our common class curriculum is built around starting science and technology education off early, from a specialized honors core curriculum
to applying core scientific principles in the lab.
Because that's what being a SciTech student is all about.